is rounding numbers. So in previous lecture, we'll discuss few questions of exercise 51 and exercise 52, question number 1 to 5 is already completed. Now we'll first of all we will discuss question number 6 and 7 of exercise 52. Now, sixth question is, express each of the following fractions as decimal. Correct to 3 decimal places. Correct to 3 decimal places. Now, sixth question, first part is 5/13. Now students, 5 is a numerator and 13 is a denominator. So we will divide 5 by 13. Yeah. Now we can't divide. First put here 0 and here 0. Now students, divide 13, 3 are 39, 10 minus 9, 1 and 1, another once again 0. Now we will divide by 8, 13, 8 are 104. Ten minus four, six. Zero. Now we'll divide by 4. 52. 10 minus 2, 8. 0. 13, 6 are 78. Yes, friends, we are finding the value correct to 3 decimal places. So we will do this division up to 4 digits. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now find the correct value up to 3 decimal places. Now our question is 0.3846. Now your third number is 1, 2, 3. Now put your finger and observe the next number. This is 6. Students, if this number is 5 or greater than 5, then this number will be increased for one step. So our answer is 0.385, because our fourth digit is 6. Now answer is 0.385. Clear, students? Now we will solve few questions of few parts of sixth question. Now part B is 6/7. Now divide 6 by 7, because numerator is 6 and denominator is 7. First put here 0 and here 0. In first step, we will divide by 8. 56. Now 60 minus 56 is 4. 0. Now 75 are 35. Now 40 minus 35 is 5. 0. Now we'll divide by 7. 7 are 49. Fifty minus 49 is 1. Once again 0. At last we will divide by 1. Now we have after decimal 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 digits. 4 numbers. Now write here 0.8571. Now we want the correct value up to 3 decimal places. Third decimal place number is 1, 2, 3. Now put your finger here and observe the next number. This is 1. 1 is less than 5. So our answer is 0.857. Because this number is less than 5. Answer is 0.857. Clear, students? This is part B. Exercise 52, sixth question, B part. Dear students, now C part, 5 upon 11. C part. Now your number is, statement is 5 upon 11. Now numerator is 5 and denominator is 11. So we will divide 5 by 11. Divide by 11. We can't divide, put here 0. And in question 0. In first step we will divide by 4. 44. 50 minus 44 is 6. 0. Now divide by 5. 55. Now 60 minus 55 is 5. 0. Once again we'll divide by 4. 50 minus 44 is 6. 0. Divide by 5. Now your answer, quotient is 0.4545. Now your decimal is 1, 2, 3. Now put your finger and next digit is 5. So this number will increase. Now your answer is 0.455. 0.455. C part of sixth question. Clear, students? Now part D. Six upon 30. Now we will divide 6 by 30. Put here 0 and put 0 point. Now 13 for in first step we will divide by 4. 13, 4 are 52. Dear students, now 60 minus 52 is 8, 0. Now we'll divide by 6, 13, 6 are 78. Eighty minus 78 is 2, 0. Divide by 1, 13. 20 minus 13 is 7, 0. Now 13, 5 are 65. So we'll solve to 3 decimals, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now find the correct value up to 3 decimal place. 0.4615. 1, 2, 3. Now put your finger and our next digit is 5. So our answer is 0.462. Now, students, we will one more question, that is part F, 3, 1 upon 11. F part of sixth question, 3, 4 upon 11. First, we will convert this mixed fraction number into improper fraction. 11, 3 are 33. 33 plus 4, 37. 37 upon 11. Now, students, divide 37 by 11. First, divide by 3. 33. Now 37 minus 33 is 4. Yes, 4. Now put here 0 and here point. Now once again divide by 3. 33. 40 minus 33 is 7, 0. Now we'll divide by 6. 66. Now 70 minus 66 is 4. 0. Divide by 3. 33. And 7. 0. 6. Now we'll solve this part up to 4 decimal places. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now find the correct value up to 3 decimal places. The question is 3.3636. Now answer is, after 3 digits, 1, 2, 3. Next digit is 6, which is greater than 5. It means your answer is 3.364. Answer is 3.364. Now, students, you'll solve part E, G, and H of 6th question. Yes. Next question is question number 7th. Think of rounding to the nearest one. What number could be rounded to? Question number 7th. Rounding to the nearest one. Nearest one. What numbers be rounded to? Your first part is 11.0. Students, it means we already round up this number and get answer 11. Now think what numbers should be which we can round it 11.0. So students, it is half of 10 and less of 11 and half. So the number would be greater than 10.5. Now, in other words, you can say numbers between 10.5 to 11.4. It means jo number 10.5 se leke 10.4 ke beech mein jitne bhi decimal numbers hain unko hum round off kar sakte hain 11. Now, to check your answer, just check 10. Next number is 5. Now round off this number. Two ones. This is 5. So this number is 11. Now round off this number, 11.4. Now put your finger. Next digit is 4. So your number is 11. So numbers between 10.5 to 11.4, we can round as a 11.0. Clear, students? Next is B part 17.0. Number two, 16.5 to 17.4. Now, part C, 20.0. So numbers will be 19.5 to 20.4. Next is last question, part D, 46.0. So numbers will be 45.5 to 46.4. Dear students, now your exercise 52 is completed. Now your homework is complete exercise 52 in your fair notebooks. Dear students, now students. We will start a new topic, that is triangles. Our next topic is triangles. First of all, what is triangle? A triangle is a simple closed figure which is made by joining the three line segments. For example, A, B, C is a triangle. This is made, first of all, this is a closed figure, and this is made by joining the three line segments. First, second and third. So this is a triangle. Students, a triangle has three vertices, three angles and three sides. A triangle means three vertices, three angles or three sides. And this is a symbol of triangle. This is your triangle ABC. If we want to write triangle ABC, first we will put the symbol, then write triangle ABC. Clear, students? Next is vertices. So what are vertices? Vertices are those points where two line segments meet. For example, A, B and C. These are vertices of this triangle. Vertices are A, B, and C. These are three vertices, A, B, and C. Next put up, three sides. Three sides are, first side is AB, second BC, third is CA. These are three sides of this triangle. Side AB, BC, and CA. Write the sides. Sides are AB, BC, and CA. These are three sides of this triangle. Yes. Next is angles. Angles are, these are angles. This part. Angle A. This is angle B. And this part is angle C. These are three angles of a triangle. When we write the angles, first we will put the symbol of angle. That is, it means angle. Angle A. Next is angle B. Next is angle C. So in triangle has three vertices, three sides, and three angles. Vertices are ABC, sides AB, BC, CA. And angles, angle A, B, and C. These are angles. First, these points are. These are vertices. These are sides. And these are three angles of this triangle. Dear students, now this lecture is over. Thank you. Have a nice day. And your homework is solve exercise 52.